Hi everybody, Sanbonani. Welcome to Reality Bites TV, where we talk about all things reality TV shows and all things reality TV show stars. So, you guys, as sometimes, attend my gossip channels, but then when we gossip, you guys, some of you, because some of you, we have fun, but some of you will be having a problem with the fact that it's a gossip. So let's gossip, okay? Now, you guys, I did a video where I asked the question, Yokuti, did Vuyo pay her own lobola? It was a question. And the reason I was asking is just because this guy was said to not have money last month to send her those flowers and the balloons because somebody had claimed that he had borrowed 2,000 rands from her to be able to pay for the flowers to send to Vuyo. So I was like, last month this guy didn't have money to buy flowers, but this month he has enough money to send people to pay Lobol. Okay, I guess we'll find out later if he is as rich as some of you are saying, because some of you are in the comment section, like you have seen the bank statement of this guy. Okay, some of you are like, this guy is rich, you know, when you convert the pounds to a rand, do you even know? Somebody said, do you even know? Because I'm like, yo, yes, you guys are so easy to convince sometimes. So a lot of people are believing what this guy is rich, this guy is doing much better than Mpumelelo financially, and I'm not convinced yet, you guys. And I do want Vuyo to be happy. I really wish Vuyo the best, and I hope that she's happy. However, it's very difficult to see that future for her with everything that is coming out about this guy. And it's hard to ignore that there are all these people that are coming out to say, this guy owes me money. There's a lady now that is umashonisa, meaning ubolekisa ngemali. And Xolani borrowed money from this lady. And it's been a long time, this lady trying to get her money. Now, you guys, this is a person that has become a public figure, and if the negotiations go well, he might end up being a reality TV star. So he knows what, if he owes somebody money, that thing is going to be made public very soon because he's becoming a public figure now. Now, if he had the money, I'm thinking he would pay it just so he's not embarrassed by all of these stories coming out. The fact that he hasn't paid the money, because he's promising this lady that by the 15th, the money will be in her bank account. If it's not in the bank account, this lady can go talk to blogs if she wants. And this lady has approached Lady Londi with the story. Now, that tells me that on the 15th, the guy didn't pay the money. Okay. But he paid the lobola. Now, it's not making sense, you guys, because even him, he's on the voice note admitting, yes, I owe you money. Can you just wait for me for the 15th? Now, this is a person that some of you are saying, this guy is rich. Some of you are saying, this guy is loaded. Some of you are saying, money is not a problem. Even Namba Kongi, they were saying, money is not a problem. But if money is not a problem and he owes people money, why is he asking for people to wait for the 15th? Because that is what we do, some of us. Where money is the issue. We say, listen, Zokbonange pay day, you know? But when money is not an issue, you can actually pay your debts at any day, on the first, on the second, on the third, on the fifth. If money is not an issue, if you are loaded, you can pay your debts at any time. Somebody calls you, Akbangelisicefe, you pay them, okay? So I'd leave it to you guys to decide. If you still think that this guy is loaded, I guess, I mean, time will tell, because you know, it always does, okay? Now, to be honest with you, I was low-key hoping with this guy, somebody said, hey, you guys will see Uvuyo must say shad. I was hoping that happens for Uvuyo, because Uvuyo has been through a lot with Mpumelelo. And, it would be embarrassing for her if this whole thing doesn't work out. But it doesn't look like my chances maning of this working out because of all of these stories that are coming out. Guys, there is smoke sometimes, you know, and you're like, okay, there might not be fire. Maybe people are just smoking hookah, okay? But then, like, if the smoke is becoming bigger and bigger and bigger and darker and darker and darker, it definitely there is fire there, okay? Are we supposed to ignore the smoke, okay? Or are we supposed to go look, you know, is the fire here? I don't know, you guys. You decide. Anyway, I'll play for you here the voice recordings, and then you can decide, you guys. By the way, thanks to Lady Londi, our resident source at this point in time, okay? We need to recognize. Thank you so much for watching this video. Sizohlangana kuma comment section. Ningitshela ke ngo Rich Xolani. Nkosi yami, yazi, I wish uVuyo found like a nice guy. Nice guy. Ongathandi nepublicity, ongathandi nokuba public, and rich. I wish that the guy was really rich. I this one, guys, and as maybe he will prove us wrong, but I am Gabo Nama Riches. Anyway, thank you so much for watching this video. Please make sure that you like it and also share it with your friends, with your family, and even with strangers in Tanda Kakuru.
Yabo nje ngingasamthola ecingweni ngaze ngafonela ex-wife wakhe ukuqala uLondi. Hayi, ngilentuze umazo njalo, sengithi uLondi, sorry. Naye angikhalele usiswa abantu ethi nakade ahlukana noXolani. Naye uXolani uyamkweleta. Nginawo ngisho ama-screenshot ngikhuluma naye lo sisi lo. Imali oyiboleka last year ngo-March, mina vele ngibolekise ngemali kodwa ngangakaze ngimboleke yena. Nokuthi weyizwe ngenye intombazane shuthe nayo ifuna kwenye intombazane esebenza ebhenki egalero. Le ntombazane iwumakhelwane wami, so yathi cela ukuthi ingikhulumise nayo uXolani, ufuna ukuboleka imali. Ngakhuluma naye-ke. Kashuthi vele mina ngiyamazi cause usisi wami ushadele kaSabela and bebesonta naye esontweni elilodwa. Ngiyabazi noma nonkosikazi wakhe ayishade naye uXolani. So ngamnika kanjalo ngoba ngithi ngiyamthemba ukuthi uzoyibuyisa imali lutho. Kunaloku vele adelele njengoba nje adesha ukuthi imali yami sengizoyithola kuLondi mabuthi ngikhuluma noLondi. Kodwa mina ngiyasa nginike imali. Khona enye ifoni enye engiyisebenzisayo. Ngizokusendela ama-screenshots ngikhuluma no-ex-wife wakhe okuqala naye uyamkweleta akaze amkhokhele. Angazi noma agcine emtholile noma agcine engamtholanga cause besinenkinga eyodwa nami naye. Nami ngangithi ngifuna imali yami. Kuyena u-ex-wife ngithi mhlawumbe basaxhumana naye uXolani kanti naye uyamkweleta abaxhumani. Uney'nkinga nje uXolani bandle. Angiyazi mina indaba yakhe kodwa mina imali yami ngiyayifuna.
Akuwonisha wentombazane ukuthi phuma ey'ndabeni zami eziphesonali. Awuzwa uyaqhubeka namanje. Awuzwa phindile ngakuwonisha ngathi phuma ezindabeni zami eziphesonali. Into engizoyenza mfethu njengoba ngangikuchazelile ngithi ngicela ungilinde kube yileli sonto lamhla ka-15 then ngizoyithumela mina from la direct kwena. Mengingakwenzi-ke lo guy usungakwenza ofuna ukukwenza mfethu. Ngiyaxolisa ukuthi ngifake imali kumuntu kumele ayithumele kwena and akangiphendule, which means uyidlile. Uyang ignore and straight. So bengicela ungilinda umhla 15 nje, it's in 10 days ngalelo viki lamhla ka 15 ngizokufakela imali yakho. Ngizoyifaka ngapha uyireceive wena ngalapho, ngizokuchazela yonke into ukuthi uzoyithola kanjani, yabo. Ya ngicela nje ungilinda, if it's fine noma ungangangiphendula silinde lolo suku lelo viki kahle kahle. So ngizokwazi kahle mina Thursday ukuthi kahle kahle ngizoyifaka nini imali eyakho ngalelo viki. Ngilala early ngivuke late, ngimfonele from ekuseni ngiphaphama akayibambi phone fethu and manje angisathandi, angikwazi ukwenza i-transfer engemanje because ngilinda u-15 days. Ngiyenzile i-transfer end of the month, ngilinda u-15 days ukuze ngenzenye. Uma ukuthi ugcine idileya ukuyifaka, bengicela ukuyifaka straight kuwena owamanje. Angisayifuni into ezongikhulumisa, ngiyifake kuyena ngoba bengimthemba, bekhonte into abengisiza ngayo for the past couple of months. Ngase ngithi akakufakele imali engiyithumele kuyena. So angazi ngoba izolo ebusuku ubethe usemsebenzini, uzoyenza namhlanje ekuseni. Namhlanje ngimfonile ngaba u-10 akabambi ifoni, kaze kuthumele ne-screenshot bengakuphendula. Angazi noma ulele noma ubhizi, ngoba uthe u-off namhlanje, uzohamba nomndeni wakhe beyogrosa or something.